Welcome to MCN and one of the most beautiful places in the entire world. We're at Mugello Racetrack and we're riding a very special machine. This is an Aprilia RSV4 factory and it's fitted with the FW kit, and that means factory works kit. Now, this bike you don't actually buy like this. You buy the parts to bolt on to an existing RSV4 RF factory. And I'll just run through what you get. So you can kind of pick and choose what you want to fit to your bike. Engine-wise, the FW kit comes with new pistons and new cylinder heads and a new ECU. And that jacks the power up to 215 bhp. It's also got a full Akrapovic exhaust. You've got a lighter tank as well. And all those weight savings add up to 10 kilos less weight. And the most noticeable difference, as I'm sure you're all aware, is that this bike has got wings. So straight from MotoGP, this has got wings, and probably the best place to test it in the world is Mugello, where just over there, you're doing well over 180 mile an hour over a crest, and bikes like these want to take off. So the FW kit is available in dealers in around about July 2018. Now, we've asked our dear readers on our Facebook page what they'd most like to know about this bike. So we've picked the most popular questions and I'm going to answer them for you now. So, number one's the most obvious one. Can you feel the wings? Well, the wings, incidentally, these bolt onto your existing fairing. You're given a template and it's just a question of drilling your fairing and bolting the wings on. And they're a lot more sturdy than I thought they'd be. In pictures and on TV, they look quite flimsy, but they're big, solid old things. But can you feel them? What I would say is, along this straight, once you get there, the bike is incredibly stable. It's doing over 180 mile an hour, but it feels like it's only doing 80. And it doesn't take off like bikes normally do there. The last bike I rode here was the Carbon Superleggera, and that was all over the place over that hill. So this is very, very stable. So you can only say that the downforce of the wings is helping keeping the bike planted. And it's also extremely good under braking at the end of the straight as well. So whether it's the wings doing that, or the inherent stability of the Aprilia anyway, or the fantastic electronics that are on this bike, it's hard to say, but they definitely work in MotoGP because they wouldn't have them otherwise. So you've got to say they work here. Whether they work down your local high street when you're tooting it along is open to question, but they look cool anyway. So the next question is, do these changes make this bike too much of a race bike? Well, in terms of feeling like a race bike, it's very small like a race bike. You've got to remember that this bike was kind of built around Biaggi way back when. So it's tiny and it's a bit too small for me, to be honest. I struggle to get my feet on the pegs and the bars are quite narrow. It handles like a race bike. The reduction in weight and the amount of power it's got just sends this bike around this circuit just so easily and so quickly. But it's not too much. I mean, the character of this bike with the V4 engine feels very docile, actually. And you don't know you're doing the speed until you actually look down and see how fast you're going. So even if you were to put these modifications on for the road, which you're not supposed to because Aprilia don't honour the warranty, everything here is track only, it would still be quite docile. But in terms of hopping up your factory for track days or racing, then this is perfect. Another big question, how does this bike compare to the BMW HB4 Race? Something everyone's asking. In terms of lightness, well, you can't match the BMW. That weighs 146 kilos dry, 170 odd when it's fully fueled. So it's a lot lighter than this bike. And you know, it's 70 grand and this bike's well under half of that price. So, you know, the Beamer is still the most pure track bike. It's interesting actually, compared to other superbikes. We've done a lot with the V4 Panigale this year. The V4 has got a lot more mid-range. It's a lot more agile, probably nicer on the brakes, but not as stable as the Aprilia. The Aprilia is much sort of smoother handling, but hasn't quite got the grunt as it wouldn't because it's a 1000cc instead of an 1100cc. And the final question people are asking are there any changes to the electronics? Well, the electronics package on here is identical to the RR and the RF, but they didn't really need to change anything because the electronics on RSVs have always been superb, all the way from when the APRC package came available. So everything from the quick shifter to the auto blipper to the anti-wheelie to the traction control, the engine braking control and everything in between is just really, really smooth and makes this bike so kind of docile and easy to ride. So that's our track test of the Factory Works kit done. It's been an absolute joy to ride this bike around Mugello today, and unfortunately all things have got to come to an end, and we're out of here.